We all have our differences, no? Maraming mga bagay na iba-iba tayo, of course. Iba-iba ang pananaw natin, iba-iba ang opinion natin, no? Unfortunately, we tend to judge one another because of those differences. And I'll explain in a little while kung ano ibig sabihin ng judging one another. Now, we do this in various ways. Sometimes we distance ourselves in subtle ways, okay, from those who are different from us. Siguro, sumisimple lang tayo, nilalayuan natin yung tao. At other times, we reject people outright, no? Talagang tahasan, you know, ipapakita natin that we don't want them around or we don't want to be near them. In some situations, we may even attack or insult people who are different from us. For example, yung cyberbullying, very common today. There is this one news report that I was reading about concerning a Japanese actress, no? And the commit ng suicide because of cyberbullying. And of course, that's just one example among many, no? Maraming mga tao ngayon, and kahit na hindi sa social media, even physically, there is bullying, no? Whenever people tend to either reject or attack somebody because of his or her opinions, you know, or looks or whatever. So this is wrong, no? As God's people, and we are talking about siempre how we are to live in view of the gospel, as we have reflected on Romans 12 verses 1 and 2, we're still in the same topic dito. Paul is explaining and, you know, clarifying ano yung implication ng gospel sa buhay natin. We are to love one another, gaya ng sinabi niya, di ba? We are to show sincere love. We are to be submissive toward the governing authorities, okay? And we are also to, you know, love people outside, you know, in the world, you know? We are not to be parang arrogant toward them, you know? Not in any way, because we are God's people. So Romans 13 has been very challenging for us. But now we are in Romans 14. And Paul continues the same theme, no? About living a life of love, you know, renewing our minds, choosing to live in the spirit, no? Which is different from those who live in the flesh. So our passage today, no, is Romans 14. Verses 1 to 12. And this goes on again, Romans 15, of course, the same topic, no, about how we are to relate to each other, especially pagdating sa mga differences natin. But starting in verse 1, ganito ang sabi. Accept him whose faith is weak, without passing judgment on disputable matters. One man's faith allows him to eat everything, but another man whose faith is weak eats only vegetables. The man who eats everything must not look down on him who does not, and the man who does not eat everything must not condemn the man who does. For God has accepted him. Who are you to judge someone else's servant? To his own master he stands or falls, and he will stand, for the Lord is able to make him stand. Verse 5, one man considers one day more sacred than another. Another man considers every day alike. Each one should be fully convinced in his own mind. He who regards one day as special does so to the Lord. He who eats meat eats to the Lord. For he gives thanks to God and he abstains. And he who abstains does so to the Lord and give thanks to God. For none of us lives to himself alone, and none of us dies to himself alone. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. For this very reason, Christ died and returned to life, so that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. Verse 10, you then, why do you judge your brother, or why do you look down on your brother? For we will all stand before God's judgment seat. It is written, as surely as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bow before me, every tongue will confess to God. And then finally in verse 12, so then each of us will give an account of himself to God. So tayong lahat po ay manalangin and let's ask the Lord for His grace and help as we meditate on His Word today. Lord God, tulungan niyo po kami, Panginoon, by Your grace, that we may understand Your message to us. Lord, renew our minds, just as You said in Your words of Romans 12, that You want us to be renewed in our minds, so that we would know Your will, Your good, pleasing, and perfect will. So, Lord, would You do that right now? Tulungan niyo kami na magkaroon ng renewal of our minds, lalo na patungkol dito sa issue na ito of differences and disagreements and so forth. So, Lord, by Your grace, tulungan niyo po kami, Panginoon, so that we may understand clearly what Your Spirit is saying. This we pray, in Jesus' name, amen and amen. So the title of our devotions today is Warning Against Judging One Another. Now, of course, even yung topic na to, we can all have our differences. And so, why we should not judge one another? Yan yung ating question eh. Why should we not judge one another? Really? Okay? And Paul talks about it dito sa passage na to. Now, during his time, you know, may mga nangyayari ng ganon. And so, more so, even now, nangyayari din yan. And when we speak about, you know, judging one another, there's a particular meaning to that na kailangan natin i-clarify. So, let's look at three reasons na sinasabi ni Paul tungkol sa bagay nito, no? The first reason is this. We have all been accepted by God through the gospel. So we should not judge one another because we have all been accepted by God through the gospel. Verses 1 to 4. So lahat tayo ay tinanggap ng Panginoon sa pamamagitan ng mabuting balita. Now sabi sa verse 1, which is the main thesis dito sa passage na to, accept Him whose faith is weak without passing judgment on disputable matters. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin nun? Now, of course, malalaman natin kung ano ibig sabihin ni Paul dun sa whose faith is weak. Sino ba yun? Okay? But before we go there, let's try to understand yung without passing judgment on disputable matters. Sometimes people think na, you know, you are being judgmental when you are parang arguing a particular position or case, no? Na maaari magkaiba kayo sa isang tao. Now, that's not the meaning of Paul by yung sinasabi niya without passing judgment. No, hindi ibig sabihin na hindi tayo pwede magkaroon ng disagreement sa mga bagay-bagay. You know? In fact, Paul himself, you know, as we are going to read the rest of chapter 14 and also chapter 15, he would state his position. So, having a position is not wrong, no? Having a certain conviction about something, even if it's different from another person's conviction, is not wrong per se. Minsan tayo, we have this misunderstanding na kapag meron tayong pinaniniwalaan to ko sa isang bagay, you know, hindi tama yun. Dapat wag natin sasabihin yun. Like, you know, what happened recently. You know, I, for example, stated my position concerning my belief about, you know, sa election, the previous election. Now, tapos na yun, so we should not discuss this anymore. But just to illustrate, some people were upset na I took a position. So taking a position is not by itself the thing na sinasabi ni Paul dito, you know? Without passing judgment on disputable matters doesn't mean it's wrong to have disputable matters. May mga bagay that we may not agree with at present, and so we use our reasoning, our intuition, the facts that we have, experience, and authority. We discuss these things, you know, in order to arrive at some kind of agreement or consensus or even maybe to agree to disagree. Pero hindi yun ang sinasabi ni Paul. He's not talking about yung idea na parang hindi tayo pwede magkaroon ng kakaibahan sa isa't isa o mga pananaw natin ay maaring iba sa isa't isa. Okay? You know, one way of looking at it is in verse 10, although we're going to look at that. Sabi niya, you then, why do you judge your brother or why do you look down on your brother? So, yung looking down, you know. In other words, it's either, pag sinabi natin to judge, doesn't mean na parang we make a distinction between right and wrong. To judge means we condemn the person, you know. We reject that person, halimbawa, we don't want to have anything to do with that person. Nagdo-draw tayo ng line and we're basically saying, di na tayo magkaibigan, or I won't talk to you anymore, no? Or huwag mo akong kausapin kasi magkaiba tayo ng pananaw. That's judging, okay? O kaya, we might even go on the other direction and really attack or insult a person. No, yung talagang meron tayong mga verbal na missiles, no, na itatapon sa kanya. We attack or even minsan violence pa, no? We use our force to ika nga control the other person who has a different view from us. That is the meaning of, you know, yung pinag-uusapan natin dito, yung without passing judgment on disputable matters. Now, in fact, sa ibang translation, it is helpful to see. Sabi ganito sa New American Standard Bible, no? Now, accept the one who is weak in faith, but not for the purpose of passing judgment on his opinions. So, in other words, you are not parang, you know, drawing the line and saying, na, well, you know, dahil dyan sa opinion mo na yan, hindi na tayo pwede mag-usap. Again, another good translation, which is a paraphrase, is yung The Message Bible. Let me read that. Sabi niya, welcome with open arms, fellow believers who don't see things the way you do. And don't jump all over them every time they do or say something you don't agree with. Even when it seems that they are strong on opinions but weak in the faith department. Remember, they have their own history to deal with. Treat them gently. I think that captures basically what the Apostle Paul is really trying to say. You know, dito sa New International Version, na mas maikli ang version, sabi ganyan, without passing judgment on disputable matters. In other words, maging kind ka doon sa mga tao na magkaiba ng view sa iyo. Huwag mo silang i-cancel out, yung parang di mo na sila friend, yung ayaw mo na silang kausapin, o kaya you would throw insults at them. This is the kind of judging one another that the Bible speaks about na hindi natin dapat ginagawa sa isa't isa. Now, Paul gives the reasons why. The first reason, gaya nga sinabi ko kanina, is that we have all been accepted by God through the gospel. So let's look at that. Starting in verse 2, sabi, one man's faith allows him to eat everything, but another man whose faith is weak eats only vegetables. So, di ba tinatanong natin sino yung sinasabi ni Paul na accept him whose faith is weak? So ito yung sinasabi niya, pinapaliwanag niya, someone who only eats vegetables. Now, of course, religious yung tinutukoy niya dito, hindi yung parang diet lang, no? He's talking about, you know, certain practices ng mga tao based on their religious beliefs. So, vegetables lang sila kasi, you know, ang tinutukoy ni Paul dito, yung mga Jewish Christians who cannot yet parang overcome yung kanilang... Siyempre, they have lived all their life based on the dietary laws of Moses. So, may mga pagkain na hindi nila kinakain. Now, Paul calls them, you know, those whose faith is weak. Now, not to put them down, but basically saying they don't have the faith enough para kumain ng kahit anong pagkain. So, may mga tao siguro kayo na-meet na ganyan. Minsan, ayaw nila na dinuguan or whatever. No, may issue sila doon. No? So, they don't have the faith yet to overcome those parang limitations. Kasi iniisip nila nagkakasala sila pag kumain sila ng certain kinds of foods. Of course, again, it doesn't mean that Paul is not interested in discussing these things. Kasi, you know, when we hold a certain opinion about something, siyempre we must be open to reason and yes, we may even have to discuss it, no? Without going into a judgmental attitude toward each other. Pero, pwede naman magkaroon ng legitimate and sincere discussion. Kasi hindi naman totoo na lahat na lang tama, lahat na lang ng bagay, sige, acceptin mo na lang, no? Parang yung, parang minsan yung philosophy ng mga tao na truth is what is true to you. In other words, relative lang ang truth. If it is true to you, then okay na yun. I have no right to judge. But this is not what the scripture teaches. What the scripture teaches is that may mga bagay na tama, may mga bagay na mali. And sometimes we have to talk about it and discuss it. And yun yung dapat natin ma-distinguish. Kasi in discussing, or sabihin natin, nagdi-disagree tayo sa isang bagay, it should not come to the point na parang we reject one another, we condemn each other, we attack one another. We can actually be discussing something in a reasonable and calm manner. And of course, ang goal natin is to arrive at the truth. So wag natin i-misread ito to mean na parang si Paul is saying wag tayong mag-discuss, wag tayong magkaroon ng posisyon sa anumang bagay, parang lahat na lang tama. Hindi yun ang sinasabi ni Paul, because Paul himself argues in the book of Romans concerning itong justification by faith. Talagang he went through a lot of chapters, di ba? Trying to argue na ito lang the only way to be saved, which is through faith in Jesus. So Paul himself, by his example, tells us na hindi yun ang ibig niyang sabihin by not passing judgment. Hindi yung hindi na tayo pwede magkaroon ng tama at mali. Okay? So sabi niya rito sa verse 3, the man who eats everything must not look down on him who does not. And the man who does not eat everything must not condemn the man who does. For God has accepted him. So ito yung ibig sabihin ng passing judgment. Yung looking down, you know? Parang kino-condemn natin, no? Sa New American Standard again, ano? Sabi sa Bible, no? Sa this translation, yung New American Standard Bible. The one who eats is not to regard with contempt the man who does not eat, and the one who does not eat is not to judge the one who eats, for God has accepted him. Okay, so in other words, you know, when we look at the NIV, yun yung implication noon. We are not to look down. Okay? Ang reason, sabi ni Paul, for God has accepted him. Now, of course, ang background nito is the gospel. That's why sabi ko, we have all been accepted by God through the gospel. Pare-pareho lang tayo, naging bahagi ng katawan ni Kristo, not because of our goodness or any other qualification on us, but because of Jesus Christ, what He has done on the cross, on our behalf. And because we have put our faith in Him, lahat tayo and accept ni God sa kanyang pamilya, you know, regardless of our background or ethnic identities, whatever, no? So sabi ni, you know, ni Paul, who are you to judge someone else's servant? So the moment na ang isang tao ay makipag-isa kay Kristo, he or she now belongs to the Lord, and he or she is now, ika nga, pagmimiari ng Panginoon. He is now a servant of the Lord. So sabi ni Paul, to his own master, he stands or falls. In other words, there is that personal or individual accountability ng tao na yun before God. And the Bible says, he will stand. Okay? For the Lord is able to make him stand. In other words, the Lord is at work in his life, in our life, in each person's life. So bago tayo mag-condemn, bago tayo mag-draw ng line, ayaw na kitang kausapin, or wag kang lalapit sa akin, o kaya I would throw some insults on you kasi iba yung opinion mo, iba yung view mo about something. Before you do that, remember, bawat isa sa atin ay tinanggap ng Panginoon sa kanyang pamilya simply because of our faith in Jesus Christ. Not because of our opinions or whatever. It's not even based on our knowledge of things. No? We don't really know everything. In fact, sometimes meron tayong mga alam na mali naman. No? We have wrong opinions about certain things. Again, what Paul is talking about dito is not yung idea na kailangan pag-usapan natin ang mga bagay-bagay o kaya, you know, mali ba na magkaroon ako ng opinion tukos sa isang bagay? Hindi yun ang tinutukoy niya. I mean, that's a given. You know? Lalo na sa mga bagay na maari magkakaiba tayo, it's only right that you state your position and you say, this is what I believe in. And if we disagree, no, doon papasok yung disputable matter na sinasabi ni Paul. We disagree about it. Okay lang yun. We can discuss and reason out and try to understand each other's point of view. And maybe come to the conclusion, okay, I cannot agree with what you say and you do not agree with what I say. And that's all right. Ang problem is when we begin to condemn or look down on one another, we begin to reject each other. No? Lalo na ngayon sa social media, usong-uso yung mga may mga bagong features ngayon. Pwede mo nang i-mute o ano ba yun, parang i-limit para hindi mo makita yung tao o kaya, di ba, worst case scenario, i-unfriend mo siya. These are all judgments. You are making a judgment of another person just because hindi kayo nag-a-agree. So, what Paul is saying is that it is not wrong na magkaroon ng mga disagreements. What is wrong is kapag binibreak natin yung principle of love and acceptance dahil lang sa pagkakaiba ng ating opinion sa mga bagay-bagay. So the first reason is that we have all been accepted by God through the gospel. Secondly, we are all accountable to the Lord Jesus. Okay? Lahat tayo accountable sa Panginoon in everything that we say or do or whatever. So tingnan natin tong verses, 5 to 9. Sabi, one man considers one day more sacred than another. Another man considers every day alike. Each one should be fully convinced in his own mind. So here, makikita natin, lumipat ng topic si Paul, tukol na doon sa mga sacred days. Again, because yung mga Jews, of course, hindi lang sa pagkain, sila medyo meticulous. Pagdating sa mga araw, lalo na yung Sabbath, no? They can be very strong about that. So, sabi ni Apostle Paul, okay, one person considers one day more sacred than another. Another man considers every day alike. So, yung word na consider means, you know, sa opinion natin, no, ganun yung tama, ganun yung katotohanan. Pero sabi ni Paul, each one should be fully convinced in his own mind. So, in other words, there's nothing wrong with having a conviction about something. Hindi siya mali na pag sinabi natin, ako, I believe ganito, ganyan. There's nothing wrong with that. Please, wag tayo magkaroon ng ganun parang immature attitude na when a person takes a position about something and dahil magkaiba kayo, parang mali na for him to take such a position. Lalo na, in my case, you know, I'm a pastor. Sometimes when I state my position about a disputable matter, parang people would judge me and say, oh, bakit kanya pastor ka? You should not take a position. Now, there's nothing wrong with taking a position. All right. Ang mali is how we regard those who have different positions from us, di ba? Yun yung mali dun eh. That's the problem. When we condemn, when we write off or attack or insultuhin natin somebody who's different from us, that's when we actually transgress, you know? Kumbaga, doon tayo nagkakasalay. If somebody believes something, don't insult that person, di ba? And vice versa. Okay? Ito ang sabi ni Paul, sabi niya sa verse 6, ano? He who regards one day as special does so to the Lord. He who eats meat eats to the Lord. He gives thanks to God. And he who abstains does so to the Lord and give thanks to God. Now, two things ang sinasabi niya rito. One is, of course, na dapat lahat ng ginagawa natin should be unto the Lord. At lahat ng pinaniniwalaan natin should not just be parang opinion lang natin, but we should submit it to the Word of God. Okay? But also, one thing na dapat natin makita rito is that yung sinseridad ng isang tao when he or she is doing or taking a position about something because yun ang pinaniniwalaan niyang tama, we should learn to respect that, no? Kasi si Lord na naman ang ano niya, ang kanyang tinatry na i-please. So verse 7, sabi, for none of us lives to himself alone and none of us dies to himself alone. Now, he's stating a fact, but he's also, you know, clarifying the kind of choices that we must make sa buhay natin. In other words, we should not just simply take a position, ganyan kasi gusto natin, but we should evaluate it in light of the scriptures. Most of the things na pinaniniwalaan natin should be based on authority because we don't know everything, di ba? So, pag sinabi sa atin ng isang tao na kunyari, pagdating sa medical, di ba? If you go to a doctor and the doctor says, ganito, ganyan-ganyan, or you take this medicine, or magpa-check up ka ng ganito, we believe that person because he has authority. Meron siyang experience, you know? May alam niya yung facts. Hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na, well, hindi ako maniniwala sa kanya kasi opinion niya lang yan. You know, how can you live your life like that? Diba? So, in other words, tayo po ay pinagkaisa ng Panginoon in the body of Christ. Sabi niya, for none of us lives to himself alone, and none of us dies to himself alone. And then he clarifies in verse 8, if we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So, whether we live or die, we belong to the Lord. Okay? So in other words, yung ano natin, yung main pinaka-importanting accountability natin is first and foremost to the Lord. Sabi niya, for this very reason, Christ died and returned to life so that he might be the Lord of both the dead and the living. In other words, Jesus is Lord of everything. Okay? So this is the second reason. Sabi ni Paul na, wag mong i-judge yung kapwa mo. Wag mo siyang i-unfriend. Wag mo siyang i-reject. Dahil magkaiba lang kayo ng mga paniniwala sa mga bagay-bagay, di ba? We should all be accountable to the Lord. In other words, maaaring meron siyang dahilan bakit niya ginagawa ayon o bakit meron siyang ganong klaseng conviction. What we need to do, dahil sa mga differences natin, is to talk openly and humbly and with due respect, you know, and try to understand the other person's point of view and really make a sincere effort to see yung kanyang what he sees. It's not necessary that we all agree. We can agree to disagree. We can have different opinions. You know, we can be convinced na something is right and something is wrong. Pero we should not come to the point na parang, okay, dahil iba yung paniniwala mo sa akin, so therefore I will reject you. Hindi na tayo magkaibigan. You know, we are all accountable to the Lord Jesus, sabi ni Paul. And ultimately, lahat ng ating mga pinaniniwalaan o convictions, you know, is going to be open to the Lord. Which leads us to the third very important reason. We will all stand before God. Okay? Sabi niya sa verse 10, no? If we look at verse 10, sabi niya ganito, you then, why do you judge your brother or why do you look down on your brother? For we will all stand before God's judgment seat. Now, the word judgment seat dito is often referred to that particular parang judgment seat for the purpose of giving rewards. Pero dito, what is really being referred to is that on the last day, you know, wala naman sa atin na ano eh, parang makakapag-excuse or anything, no? Because everything will be laid bare. Sabi ni Paul, it is written, as surely as I live, says the Lord, every knee will bow before me, every tongue will confess to God. So everyone, okay? Kaya sabi niya sa verse 12, so then each of us will give an account of himself to God. Now, of course, it doesn't mean na dapat tayong matakot because we have put our faith in Jesus. Sinabi na nga ni Paul yan sa mga na previous chapters na pinag-aralan natin. Now we don't have to be afraid. We are at peace with God because God has accepted us through faith in Jesus Christ. Okay? But then, you know, the point na sinasabi ni Paul dito is that only God has the right to judge ultimately. No? So we will all stand before God. Kaya hindi tayo dapat parang mag-final na dito sa mundong ito na parang, okay, mali siya, so ipa-final ko na yun. No? So, we are to treat each other with respect and love, and we can have disagreements. You know, sa church, for example, in ROCC, there are people who believe certain things na I think is wrong. I disagree with them, and maybe ganun din sila sa akin. But it's all right, you know? It doesn't mean, of course, na hindi na natin pwede pag-usapan yung mga bagay na yun. Again, that is an important clarification. Huwag po tayong dumating doon sa pananaw na, oy, huwag na natin pag-usapan yan. Well, kung importante yun, dapat natin pag-usapan. If we are different sa ating pananaw about something, I want to hear your point of view. And I want to listen talaga with sincerity of heart so that I can understand your point of view. Now, I hope you will do the same with me, that you will also try to understand why I take a different position. Now, in the end, kung mag-agree man tayo, mag-disagree tayo, what is important is the love that we have for each other. In other words, hindi tayo nagko-condemn sa isa't isa. We don't write off each other. We don't separate from each other dahil sa pagkakaiba natin. We accept each other. We worship the Lord together. We serve God together. We belong to the same church together. Even though, maaring, for the time being, we do not agree on certain things. Again, you know, of course, diba, may mga bagay that are, hindi natin masasabing talagang disputable siya. Because, you know, we have all agreed, for example, Jesus is Lord. That's why nga one of the things na dapat ginagawa natin is to find our commonality. What brings us together? Minsan kasi yung mga minor issues becomes the issues that separate us. Samantalang, you know, nakakalimutan natin that there are greater and more important things that unite us. We are children of God. We belong to the Lord. Diba? So, ito yung three reasons, okay? Unang-una, we have all been accepted by God through the gospel. So, we should not so easily parang reject each other. We are all accountable to the Lord Jesus. So, magkaroon tayo ng humility. No? Kahit na ano man yung posisyon natin. And we will all stand before God, no? One day. So, huwag tayong magpadalos-dalos na dito pa lang sa mundong ito parang ini-erase na natin ang mga tao. Kina-cancel out na natin sila. So, in other words, the gospel teaches us not to judge one another. Wag po tayong, ano, wag natin i-reject ang isa't isa o insultuin ang isa't isa just because we have differences. Yes, let's maintain those differences kasi normal lang yun. Let's listen to each other. May mga bagay na kailangan pag-usapan. We need to reason out. There's a place for dialogue. There's a place for discussion. You know, and maybe we can be persuaded to agree with our brother or sister who previously we did not agree with, pero upon consideration, you know, dapat may humility tayo, we should consider the facts. So upon consideration of facts, we can agree and tama sila, you know, so we agree. Or maybe we cannot agree because even if given the facts, we cannot find the logic of it or whatever, di ba? Ako, in my spiritual journey, I have had some views na eventually I had to change because upon the presentation of facts, na-realize ko na mali yung aking original belief. Yeah, I've had those things in my life. Okay? Those convictions. For example, yung pagiging born again ko. You know, there was a time na I used to think like this and like that, you know, that's a former religion ko. But when I was presented the Word of God, I realized na mali yun. So I changed my opinion. So in other words, tayo po ay magkaroon ng pagpapakumbaba sa isa't isa. Amen? Let's all pray. Dear Lord, patawarin mo kami na sometimes we think like the people of the world. We sometimes think in the flesh na pag merong disagreement, na tataranta kami. Pag merong mga different opinions, na iinis kami, nagagalit kami. Forgive us for sometimes, you know, jumping into the conclusion na hindi na kami pwede maging magkaibigan o magkasama because of the differences of our opinions. Lord, forgive us. And help us to have the faith and the courage to accept one another kahit na minsan may mga differences kami. But also to have the courage to discuss and dialogue, lalo na sa mga bagay na importante na kailangan maunawaan. Even if at the end of the day, we may have our own convictions or opinions. So Lord, teach us to love each other in the body of Christ, to accept one another in love, and to really live our lives nang hindi katulad ng mga tao sa mundo na sa konting bagay lang ay maghihiwalay na. Salamat po, Panginoon. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.